We're going to be looking at how we work with walls. And for that reason, we've got a very simple drawing made up of one arc here, you'll notice, and some lines as well, like so. They're all on layer zero. We're going to use those as the baseline for our walls in this simple little project. Now you'll notice, sitting down there in the bottom right-hand corner of the drawing area, we've got the design tool palette. Now this design tool palette is extremely useful, so don't close it, always leave it open. It's got lots of content in AutoCAD architecture that you'll always need to use. So for example, we're working with walls, there's our walls tab there. And you can see we've got walls available to us that we can start placing in our project. If you want to auto hide it, you can do that like so, like you can with any AutoCAD palette. I'm just going to leave that unhidden like that in the corner. Now let's have a look at these walls and how we can place them in AutoCAD architecture. Now if you go to the Home tab on the ribbon, you'll notice here we've got wall and we've also got curtain wall and curtain wall unit. Let's just go to wall first. Now as soon as I do that, lots of things pop up on the screen. Don't be fazed by that. The help screen pops up in the top right, and what's really nice there is Autodesk now pop these little sort of bubbles up. They're almost like thought bubbles. And it says, hang on a minute, while adding a wall, use Control to flip the wall. Use Shift to change the wall justification. Use Offset to reposition the wall if you want to. You can tell AutoCAD Architecture not to show you it again. When you click on that link, it won't appear again. But they're useful. They're really handy little tips, so I always leave them on, just in case there's something there that I don't know. So I'm just going to close that for now, but it will pop up again at another point, perhaps, when I'm working in AutoCAD Architecture. Now, you'll notice, because I've clicked on wall, I've now got on my pointer here, on my cursor, I've got justify baseline start point or, and that's on my dynamic input on the screen. So what it's telling me now is I need to start placing my wall. What I am going to do, I'm going to hold down the wheel on the mouse and just pan slightly so I can see all of my lines and my arc. Now, the properties palette has popped up. Now, this will happen a lot in AutoCAD Architecture, and I can now just click on browse here, and my styles browser will kick in, another palette, you'll notice. So I've now got a lot of palettes and not much screen real estate. Don't worry about that. I'll show you a way to cope with that in a minute. But you'll notice I can pick a wall type. So I've got external brick with 102 insulation, block, and 100 plaster there. So if I click on that, that will give me the wall type, and I can click on the plus sign, and I can add that object to the project here like so. So if I just double click on that, or I click on add, that adds that particular type of wall and makes it available. You'll notice it updates here in the properties. Now the good thing is I can just close the styles browser like so, and I can now still just place the wall with the properties palette open. But I don't even need the properties palette open either, because I can just use my design palette over here. So I can go, I want an external brick wall. There we go. It's exactly the same wall, but it's just on that little design palette. So I click there, and lo and behold, everything kicks in again. My little hints here, so I can close those. But I can also have it all ready to go here. So what I can do now is just literally start using my object snaps. I'll go round, and I'm just clicking away on each snap, just going around the little lines that I've got here. Now, when I get to this endpoint snap here, I click, and then I can right click and I can go arc. Now, all I've got to do here is go for the midpoint snap, which isn't actually on at the moment. So the idea would be, let's just jump down to object snaps, switch midpoint on, switch the object snaps menu off. There's my midpoint there. Just make sure I get that. Get my endpoint there. Get to this endpoint here. And then you'll notice now that's trying to do arcs. So I can right click and I can undo what I've just done. And you'll notice now, can you see I'm back in the line setting? So just be aware of that. When you undo, like you do in a lot of the context sort of sensitive kind of right clicks there, you want to make sure that you are in arc or line mode. So when I get to that endpoint snap there, I click, and you'll notice now it's done the arc again. So I've got to make sure that I go back to line mode. Like so. I've got that arc there, that's great, but I need to be able to go line like that so we know it's a line and not an arc. So just be aware of that right click, select line or select arc. It can be confusing when you first start using AutoCAD Architecture. Now, the good thing is I've done this in one continuous loop going all the way around the lines and the arc. I can right click and close, and that will close out. You'll notice the property palette disappears. If I zoom in real close though, you can see that it's used that line and all of these wall segments now. Can you see they've all got their lovely trimmed corners? The cavities are all trimmed, and my walls are now placed nice and neatly in my AutoCAD architecture project.